streaming live. This is Tracking the Tropics.
Post-tropical cyclone Lorenzo is headed for Ireland, with the rest of the tropics remaining relatively quiet as we head into the month of October. Hey there, everybody. Storm teammate meteorologist Amanda Hawley here with our regularly scheduled edition of Tracking the Tropics on this Wednesday. It's October 2nd, and it's 1:30 here Eastern, 12:30 Central. And today's featured meteorologist is a familiar face here at WFLA, Ed Bloodsworth. He's joining us now from WKRG in Mobile, Alabama. Thanks, Ed, for joining us to track the tropics today. Not a whole lot to track, right?
Always a pleasure to be with you guys. But yeah, this system now has made its transition to a post-tropical cyclone, Lorenzo. And I saw some video out of the Azores this morning. The waves have been pretty impressive with this very large circulation.
Well, we were seeing effects, very, very minimal effects from Lorenzo all the way here along the east coast of the United States in terms of those waves. I mean, Lorenzo churned out there for so long and it was so powerful that those waves propagated all the way over 2,000 miles across the Atlantic towards the east coast. And they were seeing, you know, general swells, larger swells, not, you know, rough surf conditions, but swells up to 5 feet along the east coast of Florida. So Lorenzo, yes, sat across the Atlantic, did affect the Azores Islands, and now headed for Ireland, if you can believe it. It is post-tropical, so it doesn't have that warm core, right, Ed? But it is still packing the winds.
And that's what's going to be eventually a pretty big rainmaker and, again, windmaker as well for the UK, Ireland as well. And this is actually something that we've seen in the past a lot of times when these former tropical systems in the Atlantic start moving out and becoming extra tropical. They still maintain a lot of their hurricane characteristics in terms of the large wind field, the intense surf, and you see the movement there. That's in northeast at 43, really getting swept up in that upper level trough here, but that's going to slingshot that thing in the UK. So for them, conditions are going to start going downhill for the next couple of days, and it looks like the system actually will slow down a little bit. So they could be seeing, you know, maybe a stretch of more than 24 hours of some intense weather. So folks who are traveling across the pond, well, next couple of days might not be a good trip for you. Just make sure you bring along the rain gear, because it's going to get windy and gusty there in the UK.
And on the trip over, right, if you're headed out on a cruise, maybe transatlantic cruise, you're going to be dealing with those waves that Lorenzo churned up for the past several days. But yeah, you know, in terms of a name, that's really the only difference post-tropical cyclone Lorenzo. We're still talking about those wind speeds of tropical storm force. I mean, you can see it headed for Ireland right now. The forecast as it stands will be a strong tropical storm force wind, 70 mile per hour winds headed for Ireland, and then staying a tropical storm as it heads for potentially London. So interesting situation unfolding there, but luckily it will move in relatively quickly. Tomorrow evening, it's going to forecast to be in Ireland and then headed towards London by Friday morning. So interesting situation there with Lorenzo. We're not going to be dealing with Lorenzo for very much longer. And then heading into the rest of the Atlantic, it's relatively quiet, right? I mean, compared to the month of September, where we've seen 8 named storms since Hurricane Dorian. And, you know, we're only seeing a low chance of development right now, actually headed into the Gulf, Ed.
Yeah, you know, this is something that we watched yesterday, just a very small chance here, 10 to 20%. And as it moves over the Yucatan, of course, that's going to interact with whatever this is. But even, you know, you look at a 10 to 20% chance, that's extremely low over the next couple of days. But again, this is certainly something to just keep in mind, that even as we're moving into October, we still have to certainly keep our guard up. There's still some very warm waters out there. And historically, the Gulf Coast actually tends to, again, still see some pretty significant storms in the month of October. I know actually there, you know, growing up in Tampa, where you are there, the west coast of Florida, climatologically speaking, some of their more notable storms have actually come during the month of October. Of course, the 1921 Tarpon Springs hurricane, the last major hurricane to make landfall there, happened in October. So just a good message, just to everyone needs to make sure they still have their hurricane kits ready to go.
Absolutely. I mean, this time of year, if I go to the next slide here, we're going to keep watching this area for development, but just a low chance right now as it moves into the Gulf. But this is the areas we watch during the month of October, and you can see it's a lot closer to home, whereas during the month of September, we look farther out into the Atlantic where those waves are coming off the coast of Africa. Now we look closer to home where we start to see the northern jet stream become a little bit more active. We see the cold fronts propagating through the United States, and on the tails end of those cold fronts, when they make their way into the Gulf or maybe into the Western Atlantic, we can see quick spin-ups of development. And sometimes we don't get quite as much advancement looking at the forecast models. So we do have to keep our guard up. I mean, we're just over a week away from the anniversary, the one-year anniversary of Hurricane Michael, and that was in the month of October. So certainly something we'll keep an eye on, you know, and that had only a low chance of development, and then it was only supposed to be a tropical storm, and then maybe a small hurricane, and obviously we saw what Hurricane Michael became. So never can let our guard down during the tropical season. And we've got October and November to get through. Obviously November just a little bit quieter than October, but certainly still hurricane season, right, Ed?
Yeah, and you know, of course, you notice here, we don't really tend to look towards the African continent as we move through October, but also notice we have those prevailing tracks on this graphic, and that's generally what we see. As Amanda just mentioned, we start to see these upper-level troughs. They start to dip farther south, and those will tend to steer these systems farther to the north. And as was the case with Michael last year, the storm originated exactly where we would expect, the far western portions of the Caribbean. That's where the storm initially started to form. Actually, I believe it was just there north of Honduras. Mm-hmm. And then it started to move north. And once it got into the Gulf there, they encountered still some very warm and deep warm water. And again, that we saw what that became, a Category 5, before it made landfall there near Mexico Beach. And yeah, hard to believe that we're coming up on 1 year since that storm. I remember that last year tracking it there with you there at WFLA. And I remember Ian Oliver and I were watching that morning and just thinking, my goodness, this thing is not slowing down at all. So, and we thought that there was a chance that could become a Cat 5. Of course, it was later when it was upgraded. But again, you see the prevailing tracks there. Again, we look at the east or western portions of the Atlantic, western Caribbean, still the Gulf of Mexico. And so again, we see these little invests move into this area, even like with the one we just showed you with that low chance. It's still something that bears watching over the next couple of days, as we see that we'll have a general westerly movement over the next 4 to 5 days. Amanda.
Yeah, potentially making its way, you know, across the Yucatan Peninsula, maybe into the eastern portions of the Bay of Campeche, or even the southern Gulf of Mexico. Something we'll keep an eye on. The latest GFS that I looked at, you know, had a very, very broad area of low pressure developing. But, you know, conditions, that's what we're looking at. We're looking at warm sea surface temperatures in the Gulf of Mexico. Obviously, it's, you know, the month of October. We have warm waters over the Gulf of Mexico, but we're also looking at a lot of dry air that could impede the storm as it moves in that general direction. So you can kind of see the moisture in the southern area, southern portion of your screen there, but a lot of dry air over the state of Florida, even near you, Ed, in Mobile, Alabama, you know, in the southern portions, which would limit any kind of development.
Yeah, and this pattern that you're seeing with the water vapor, this has been a very useful pattern, at least for us in the last week or so, because this is kind of what we've been seeing, a big upper-level ridge stationed over the southeast, that drier air moving over the Florida Peninsula, Gulf of Mexico, and right along the Gulf Coast. And what that has done for us is, one, it's unfortunately worsened the drought situation of the southeast. Some areas are now in severe drought, but get this, we just came off of our warmest September on record, and yesterday for October first, our average high here is 83 degrees. We should start getting those fall fronts. But we hit 97 degrees yesterday in Mobile, the hottest temperature ever recorded in Mobile, and Pensacola hit 96. So it's just incredible what this this kind of pattern does. But it looks like, thankfully, once we head into about the next 5-6 days, fronts start moving in, we'll finally break this ridge. But as you mentioned, though, once those fronts move into the Gulf of Mexico, Amanda, that's something we always have to watch this time of year for areas of low pressure to develop along those boundaries.
And we will continue to watch it here on Tracking the Tropics. Also here in the state of Florida, you know, as you know, Ed, a rainy season usually doesn't cut off until, you know, maybe early October or mid-October, but haven't really had any rain during the month of September. We had our rainy season kind of cut off very early, a couple of sprinkles here and there, but otherwise not a whole lot going on. Weather has been very quiet, but also very hot here in the state of Florida, as it has been across much of the southeast. This has been a big record-setting heat temperature-wise for the much of the south over the past month or so. So we'll continue to track the tropics, but that is the latest with Lorenzo. As we were tracking Lorenzo is post-tropical. We'll give you guys one quick little update here. Lorenzo Post Tropical headed for Ireland and potentially over towards London over the next couple of days as it's racing off to the northeast, still packing some very strong winds. Right now, still a Category 1 hurricane in terms of its wind speeds, 80-mile-per-hour winds, but staying at least a tropical storm with those tropical storm force winds headed towards Ireland and into London. Otherwise, the rest of the tropics remain relatively quiet. But if anything develops, of course, as you know, Ed, we will continue to track the tropics and we'll update you guys as needed. Otherwise, we'll have our regularly scheduled edition of Tracking the Tropics every single Wednesday for the rest of hurricane season at 1:30 Eastern, 12:30 Central, right here on this app or this website. So Ed, thank you so much for joining us again on this Wednesday for Tracking the Tropics. Always appreciate your input and, you know, just your thoughts on the tropics.
Yeah. And of course, I got to give a big shout out tonight. Go Rays for the AL wild card against the A's.
I think a lot of us are rooting for the Rays tonight. We'll see how it goes, though. But all right, everybody. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us. We will see you hopefully next Wednesday as you join us for our next edition of Tracking the Tropics.
Thank you for watching Tracking the Tropics.